I'm a little bit tired right now because I was outside turning the compost pile, hanging out with the chickens, hanging out with Rascal, running all over the yard, acting like a darn fool. But I wanted to do an update on the stuff that's going on inside because there's a lot of things still going on inside, so I don't want to neglect the indoor plants. And I also wanted to thank all of you personally, right here and right now, for all the cool seeds that you sent me. A lot of the stuff is growing, and I want to do an update on just a little bit of it. I don't have time to do an update on all of it, but anybody that sent me a seed, I want to say thank you right now to all of you, okay? Thank you for sending me the seeds. I really do appreciate it. Let me show you what I have going on right here in the house, okay? Come on in. Take a look at this. First one up on the roster is buttercrunch lettuce. Nobody sent me these seeds, but I wanted to show you anyway because it's doing really well inside, and I think it deserves a shout out. Mainly because you probably won't see it again. As fast as I've been eating this thing, it's probably going to be gone before I do another video. Every time I come up to the room to water my plants, once a day, I eat a couple leaves and is putting out as many as it can to try and keep up. But I'm winning the race. And over here is New Zealand spinach. I'm sure it's supposed to look better than this, but I've been eating it so fast, the poor thing can't keep up. I come up and I toss a piece in my mouth. It's really good. Has a really nice flavor to it. It grows fast, and unlike regular spinach, it sends out side branches with leaves. I've been growing this inside, so it's not looking that great. So I can imagine how beautiful this plant would look outside with all kinds of side branches and big, beautiful leaves. It produces more and more as it goes. You know, unlike spinach where you start picking the leaves off, eventually it bolts. I don't believe this thing is going to bolt quite as fast as regular spinach. So I have a couple other seeds that I want to plant outside this year. Whoever sent me New Zealand spinach, thank you. Somebody also sent me collard green seeds, and I had a collard green growing here, but that went away yesterday. It's in my stomach as we speak. So whoever sent me collard greens, thank you. Here's another one somebody sent me. It's called a mini chocolate bell. This plant puts out itty bitty peppers that look like regular chocolate bells, but they're really small. They're just little bell peppers that are brown, and they're supposed to be really good. The plant isn't mini, but the peppers will be mini. But one of the things a lot of people are running into at this time of year while growing their plants inside, getting them ready for outside, their plants are starting to flower. Mine are no different. Take a look up close. Yeah, it's starting to put out all kinds of buds. Now you have two choices. You can either let this thing bloom, and it's very tempting. It's so tempting because all of these will be little bitty peppers. It's very tempting for me to allow this to produce peppers, but look at how small this is. It's not a very big plant. Once this starts putting out peppers, it's going to put a lot of energy into supporting those peppers and not into growing or forming better roots. What I want right now is for this plant to have the best start it possibly can for the garden because it's got all season to go and to grow peppers. If it starts producing peppers now, it's not going to be actually taking care of itself. It's going to be taking care of its kids. So I want to make sure that it gets the best possible start it can. And as difficult as this may be, I cut it back. I leave a couple sets of leaves so that it can start bushing out at the bottom. And I don't know if you can root this or not. I've never tried. If anybody ever has tried and done it, let me know. But I've never done it, so it looks kind of drastic, but in the long run, it's really good for the plant. Take a look at another plant. It's not the same color. Let's compare these side by side. Notice the unclipped one has a thin stem, and the shoots are very tiny at the base of the leaf stalk. Whereas once you prune a plant, the stem gets thicker, and you get multiple side shoots. That's going to mean a very, very strong, bushy plant with a low center of gravity. So during the summer, when this thing's growing, it's going to be low, sturdy, strong, and you won't have to worry about a top-heavy, thin, wimpy pepper plant blowing over in the breeze. So pruning them right now is a good thing to do if you want to have a nice, healthy plant later on in the summer. That's just my tip for you. Everybody's got their own way of doing things. I just wanted to show you mine, okay? Oh, by the way, the one on the right, I call it an ancient sweet red pepper. Somebody sent me some seeds for these long red peppers, and there was a picture posted on my Facebook profile, and that's what these are. I don't know what they're called. All I know is they're long, red, and sweet, kind of like a bell pepper, but with a lot more flavor, and they're heirloom. So when these grow up in the garden, I will definitely show you what they look like. And if anybody's interested in growing these next year, tell you what, I'll save the seeds and I'll start giving them away for 2013. Next one, jujube. Yes, somebody actually sent me seeds for a plant called a jujube. And jujubes are also known for being a candy. Oh, now jujubes are also known for being a candy. Way back in ye old days, when people used to go to movie theaters, they would buy jujubes, a candy. And jujube candy was actually named after the jujube plant. Jujube plants put out a fruit that's supposed to be really good. And it's a bushy type plant, and it's got little thorns on it. And I don't know why, but this one grew really well. I actually have 4 of these. So if you sent me the jujube seeds, thank you so much. I have 4 of these growing, and I'm going to grow them inside because I don't think that they'll stand the winters out here. So I'm going to have jujubes growing in my house. All right, take a look. I made a comment about this, and it was kind of rude. I said the only miracle about this miracle fruit is that it's alive, because mine looks so anemic and so sad. I felt like it was going to die. I almost uprooted it and threw it away. I was so disgusted with it, but I am so glad I did not. I kept giving it a little bit of fertilizer, letting it dry out, watering it, let it dry out, and it paid off. Look at what it's doing right now. It's putting out these little side branches, and it has 4. It's hard to show them, but it has 4 of them, and all 4 are putting out leaves. So this is going to start bushing out and growing really fast. Somebody posted on my Facebook that just give it time, be patient, and they'll do fine. Well, whoever you are, thank you for the advice. I was patient. I followed your advice. And now my miracle fruit. Next on the list is the scorpion pepper. It's still in a cup, so it's not really that big, but it's growing extremely well. It's very healthy. Everything's going fine with it. I'm going to save the seeds from this and give the seeds away in the 2013 free seed giveaway. Wow, big deal. Well, that little green thing down there is a big deal for me because somebody sent me some seeds for what's called a jacaranda, and I planted them March 23rd, I think, and they've already germinated. It only took about a week for these to germinate. Last time this person sent me the seeds, they did not germinate, and I felt really bad because, you know, they spend money on the postage to send me seeds, and I tried everything I could. I could not get them to germinate. He sent me more seeds, and finally, I got one to germinate, so I'm taking very good care of this little thing. It's supposed to be like a viney type plant, and it produces beautiful blue flowers. So this is going to be a fun one to grow. Moving right along, this is what's called a cherry moya. Cherry moya is a tree, and it has some really funky looking fruit. And someone sent me a handful of cherry moya seeds, and they germinated. I have 4 of these growing. I was so surprised. Because with tropical trees, I've had a really hard time getting a lot of these things to grow. Apparently, cherry moya grow really well. So if you sent me these cherry moya seeds, thanks a lot. This is definitely an indoor one because it's a tropical plant. I can't grow it outside. I have no idea what I'm going to be doing with all of these tropical plants that are growing inside. I'll keep them, though. I'll keep them. Next, this is called a goji berry. Goji berries are supposed to be extremely nutritious, extremely good for you, and I think they taste good too. So this is my little goji tree. Goji bush? Goji vine? I have no idea what it's going to turn into, but for right now, it's this. I am so scientific, aren't I? And this one, some of you already know about, it's called a moringa. And moringa is an ancient tree that is, I think, called the tree of life or something like that. Whatever it is, it's grown in Middle Eastern countries a lot, and every part of the tree is edible and useful, from the leaves to the stem to the bark to the roots. Everything is good. So that's the nice thing about this plant. It can grow in a variety of climates, a variety of conditions, and it is so helpful to people who can't grow normal things in their area. They grow this and it helps them survive. So this is a very old variety of plant that is known worldwide, and I'm really glad to be growing it here. Somebody sent me some moringa seeds. I still have a few left over in case this one doesn't make it, but I think it's going to do just fine. I've tried growing these before and they died on me, but they never got this big, so I got a feeling this one's here to stay. And take a look at what I have here. This is the world's tiniest tomato plant. It's called a microtom. And a microtom is a very good plant to grow if you don't have any room, you don't want to do an outdoor garden, you want to grow something inside in a small pot, maybe in a little window. Microtom is going to be the perfect plant for that because they don't get big. And that's why I'm not pinching off these flowers, because this is going to be a very tiny plant. I think what I'm going to do is save the seeds, and anybody that wants to grow microtoms, like people that live in apartments or don't have the room for regular tomato plants, I'm going to send the seeds out in 2013. This little beauty is an old heirloom that was grown by Luke's family for, I believe, generations. Luke runs the MI Gardener channel, and he was nice enough to send me just a couple of seeds because he doesn't have a lot. He sent me a couple seeds because he wants me to grow this old heirloom and continue it. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. These are old heirloom beefsteak tomato seeds. And from what I understand, the tomato is absolutely delicious, beautiful. The plant grows so big. I'm going to grow this summer, and I'm going to taste them for myself. And if I like the taste of these tomatoes, which I am pretty sure I'm going to, I'm going to offer these seeds to everybody in the free seed giveaway, because I would like to take an old heirloom like this and make sure as many people grow it as possible. With so many strange hybrids and so much crap going on in the world of plants, it is nice to know that there are some really good old heirlooms that are grown by families, and the seeds are kept and handed down from one person to their kids to their children's children. And I want to make sure that as many people can share in something as beautiful as this. It is an absolutely beautiful plant. Look at the sturdiness on this. This is shaping up to be a really nice looking plant. So thank you, Luke, for sending me these seeds. I'm going to be growing this year out in my garden, definitely. The wonderful thing about tiggers, people told me it's actually pronounced tigger. So if you ever want to see what a tigger melon looks like, go to Google and type in tigger melon, and they are beautiful. Oh, they are a beautiful fruit. And well, they're not a fruit like a sweet fruit. They're like a cucumber and a little melon, and they're striped. Beautiful, beautiful. Can't believe that I actually got this to grow so well in an indoor pot. Now, these are going to be grown outside, and I have a special spot for those. Whoever sent me tigger melon seeds, thank you so much. Your tigger is doing fine. Now, I have no idea what this is. I received something on the Voodoo Garden Show and Tell mail day, and there was an envelope, and I showed some seeds, but one of them was a peach seed. So if you sent me something in a big envelope, and there was a peach pit in there, this is what it was. I think it was a peach pit. It could have been an apricot pit. It could have been a peach pit. It could have been a plum pit. I don't know. All I know is there was a pit in there. So I cracked the shell off of it, took the seed inside, planted it, and it sprouted, and it's growing beautifully. So I don't know what kind of tree I got growing on here. I have peach written on the tag, but I really don't know what it is. Whatever it is, it's going to grow inside, because I don't know if it'll stand the winter outside. So I think I have me a peach tree growing inside. And this is kind of cool. I've never grown one of these inside. This is actually a soybean plant. And it's not just any soybean plant. It is called, let's see if I can butcher this as little as possible. It's called Hakacho soybean. Oh, tractor. It's definitely farming season here. All these tractors are going up and down the road. I just love it. I sit out on the porch with my coffee and watch the tractors. Farmers wave to me. I think it's pretty cool. They grow soybeans around here, but they don't grow this kind of soybean. Hakacho soybean. If you sent me the Hakacho soybean seeds, thank you very much. They're actually starting to flower. They got itty bitty flowers here, and I'm going to have little soybeanettes. Now this little thing is pretty common down south, but not very common up north. It's called a Chiltepin pepper. C-H-I-L-T-E-P-I-N. Chiltepin pepper. I looked it up on Google, and some of what I read claims that this is the ancestor of all peppers. It puts out a whole bunch of little peppers. So I thought that was kind of cool. I don't know if it's true, so if it isn't true, please, please, please don't bash me for it. It's just what I saw on the internet, and we all know that if you see it on the internet, it must be true. Hear the sarcasm in my voice. But whatever it is, somebody sent me chiltepin pepper seeds, and I got them to germinate. They are extremely easy to grow, and they are self-bushing. Look at this. This plant has not been pruned, but look at what it's doing. Wow. This, if nothing else, will be a beauty when it grows up. So if you sent me these seeds, thank you. I am having a blast growing this pepper. Now this is called a Bartolo Rosso. Now I wanted to show you this not just because I think it's a beautiful plant and that it's doing well, but because it's having a little bit of an issue that you may not notice. But a friend of mine, Gabe, at the Pepper Growing Channel is having problems with his pepper plants, and he's starting to correct them. But I wanted to mention this to you because you may be having the same problems, and if I can mention it, maybe you can avoid the situation that he's going through and that I'm going through. Let me zoom in and show you what's happening here. Take a look here. These leaves are beautiful. They're a nice shade of green, great shape. Now look what's going on underneath here. These leaves are misshapen. They're kind of starting to push up here. They're not wilting. They're just curling under and getting really monstrous all the way around. These lower leaves are looking just crazy. Now, the reason that this is happening, too much nitrogen. When you give your plants too much nitrogen, what'll happen is it overgrows the green. I call this overgrowing. That's when the plant just starts going nuts. It has so much food, it doesn't know what to do with it, so it puts it into the leaves. And what's happening with the leaves is they're growing so fast and furious that they just start bowing down like that because they're growing out and it pushes them down. This isn't an unhealthy plant. I know it sounds strange. It's an overly healthy plant. And you don't want that to happen because you don't want it to just get all crazy and bent out of shape. If you have this problem with your plant, peppers, tomatoes, anything, slow down on the feeding and everything's going to be fine. It's not a game ender. Your plants aren't sick. They're not going to die. Just cut back on the feeding. A lot of people tend to pamper their plants a little bit too much. So if you see this happening with your leaves, don't panic. Nothing's going on. Just cut back on the nitrogen and look what happens. The leaves come back to normal. And growing in this bright, shiny red pot, I think it's a 14-inch pot, is my goldenberry. Whoever sent me the goldenberry seeds, thank you. But I wanted to show an update, even though I've shown these before, because they've made remarkable progress. It's flowering all over the place, but it's putting out fruit like you would not believe. I want this to grow outside, and normally with my plants, I chop them back. But no matter how much I chop this guy back, or girl, it kept putting out more flowers, so I finally gave up. Yes, my plant won. I lost. Chalk one up for nature. It decided it wanted to put out fruit and it was not going to be stopped, so I let it do it. I'm going to just let this go to town and do what it wants to do. And apparently it's doing something extremely well. So I'm going to have all kinds of goldenberry seeds, also known as ground cherries. Yeah, I think they're called ground cherries too. Well, whatever they are, they're going to have a whole heck of a lot of seeds. So if people want to grow these things, maybe I'll give away seeds in the 2013 seed giveaway. What do you think? They're absolutely beautiful. They put out these little lanterns, and inside this paper lantern is a berry. And as the berry gets bigger and bigger and bigger, it'll eventually split this wide open. Kind of cool. And last thing I wanted to bring up, I know I've said this before, but I have to continue to say it because you need to be reminded. Thank you to everybody who sends me seeds, posts comments, subscribes, and shares my videos with all of their friends, family, moms, dads, kids, everybody that you share my channel with. I do appreciate it because it brings more and more people together so that we can do more and more things. The seed giveaway has gotten bigger each year, and next year it's going to be bigger. My garden is doing phenomenal, and I want to share that with you all summer long. I'm tuning into more and more people's channels and watching their videos, which is a good thing for me because there's always room for me to learn something. If I'm not learning something, I'm not doing something right. So, I do learn from you. We share, we have a good time, and thank you so much for that. That's what makes the Practice 55712 channel what it is. It's not just me making videos, it's not just you tuning in, it's all of us getting together to do this fun stuff. And I think that's great. I think that's really great. So, thank you again to everybody who tunes in, and that means you. All right? Okay, I gotta get going. I'm gonna get these things back where they belong, underneath the lights, and get this edited so that you can watch it. All right, thanks for tuning in, everybody. I really do appreciate it, and I really do appreciate it. Have a great day, everybody. Bye.